Bang, 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 hold your hammer low. Bang, 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 give a mighty blow. For it's work, 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 every day and every night. For it's work, 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 when it's dark and when it's light. Now you pick up your pretend shovel. Dig, 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 dig your shovel deep. Dig, 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 there's no time to sleep. For it's work, 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 every day and every night. For it's work, 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 when it's dark and when it's light.
Fantastic. All right, so we're going to go back and forth to the song sheets, to those Haggadot that we have too. So Wendy, you just let me know which thing we're going to, whether song sheet or whether it is a Haggadah. So I'm going to now bring up our Haggadah so everybody can see that. And I'm going to put that up for everybody to look, and I'm going to turn it over to our friends. So as we're going through the Haggadah today, we're going to doing the different steps. Now, normally if we were in a round a table, we would have the Seder plate, we'd have our candles, and we'd begin with the candles and with our food that we'd all be sharing together around our table. So today, instead, we're going to do our kiddush. We're not going to do the candles, but we are going to do Shehecheyanu. And that's going to be the very, very first thing we're going to do as far as the steps go. But I'm going to turn it over to Wendy for the beginning of the song. We're going to do, for the beginning of the Seder, we're going to go through the order, the different steps of the Seder, beginning with Kadesh, with the Kiddush.
Again, I'm flipping between a book and a
I know,
song
I know.
Sheet.
I know,
it's a
tough.
Little crazy here. All right. Here we go. Kadesh Ochat Ar Pas Yachat Ma
Right. So now, as you heard, we're going to do our first step of the Seder is the Kadesh. And again, as we look at the first step, we're going to do the Kiddush, and we're going to do the Shehecheyanu, the blessing for when we come to special times of the year. And so for now, we're going to do the Kiddush together, and I'm going to turn this back over. So Wendy, you can see the words for the Kiddush right here. Do it in Hebrew first.
And I want everybody to sing with me. I won't be able to hear you, but please sing with me. And guess how we get to do this four times today. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri Amen. Amen.
Before we drink this, I'm going to ask Xander to read the Kiddush, the first Kiddush in English. So Xander, take it away.
We praise God, ruler of everything, who gave us a heritage that endures through the ages, ever changing and ever meaningful. We thank you for the opportunities for holiness, the obligations of your commandments, and the happiness of joyful holidays. Together we celebrate the holiday of Matzot, the time of liberation, by reading our sacred stories, remembering the Exodus, and raising our voices in song. We praise God who sanctifies the family of Israel and the holidays.
Amen. And you can drink a little grape juice if you have a little grape juice with you. If you don't have any grape juice with you for this one, make sure you get some for the other ones. Hmm. But now, wait, we have to do one other thing. Shachianu. I forgot. Because the first time we're actually doing Shachianu too, and we know this song. So I'm going to turn this over back to Wendy for us to do the Shachianu for our holidays. So you can wait till you drink or drink another drink when we do Shachianu. Go for it, Wendy.
All right. Don't forget, this one has a big, long amen in it. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shehechianu Vekimanu Vehigianu Hazman Hazeh. We do that again. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shehechianu Vekimanu Vehigianu Hazman. Amen.
Fantastic. Now I feel like we left out a song, Wendy. Did we leave out a song?
I don't think so.
Okay. Good. As long as we didn't leave out a song yet. So as we go to our next part of the Seder, and we're going to get everybody's help for these, even though our Zion class is leading services, we need everybody to be part of it today. So normally, again, if we had all of our stuff out for the next thing that we do is washing our hands. So again, washing our hands is really important to be doing right now, especially again now when everyone's using Purell and hand sanitizers and all those kind of things. We normally wash our hands now because we're going to not have food with bread in it, or in this case, unleavened bread, but we are going to have the karpas, the green vegetable. And so before we have the karpas, the green vegetable, we are going to, and again, if you have a green vegetable near you, you can get it ready because we're coming to the symbol of springtime. Just wash my hands. And I actually really did. I mean, I actually really washed my hands. Well, it's hard to do here. in my desk, I'm also doing this right now with you. And so we come to karpas, the dipping of the green vegetable into a salt water. And we're going to say a blessing over this. And we're going to ask, this is now the next blessing. And we're going to ask Sophia to help us here in the Haggadah for the blessing. We can say it in Hebrew, which again, we have this green vegetable. We dip it in our tears, the salt water. And as we have that first vegetable, we say, Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri ha'adama, which Sophia means?
We praise God, everything, who creates the fruits of the earth.
Amen. So you can eat a little bit of the green vegetable, which again is a symbol of spring, which just started yesterday, folks. We just entered into springtime, literally like 24 hours, just over 24 hours ago, we started springtime. So this is very cool that we're actually celebrating spring right at the beginning of spring, which doesn't always happen. Passover was a little earlier this year because of the lunar calendar. So that's why we're doing it right now. Well, as we go to the next part, we're going to do Yachatz, which I'm going to turn this back over to, Wendy, which is time when we're going to do, hold it 1 second. I want to get Wendy up on the screen. Oh, I got a couple. All right. So this is Sammy's part. Oh, no, excuse me. This is Sophia's part still. Sophia, I'm going to bring you up. I need to bring you up your volume a little bit because I couldn't hear you so well the last time. So I need to be able to hear Sophia. She's leading the Yachatz part.
Louder if you want.
Yeah, that's better. Okay, so let me see. Hold it 1 second. All right. Do you have a little matzo over there? So let me give you, so is there any matzo over there, Sophia?
My dad's getting it. 1 second, sorry.
All right. Sophia's got the matzo going over there in her place. Here we go. See, Sammy's got some matzo over there. All right. Bo's got some matzo. He's ready to go. All right. This is my matzo shirt, by the way. That's why I'm wearing my matzo shirt today. And we're going to get our songs ready for our next song,
which is
Halachma. Halachma.
Okay. And that's going to be in the Haggadah.
It's in the Haggadah. Actually, I don't know because I don't have your song. I just got your song sheet. So I don't...
It's not in my song sheet. Okay. So I'm hoping you have it in the Haggadah.
No, it is. It is. It is.
All right.
It is. So, all right. Ready, Sophia? Halachma.
This is the bread of poverty, which our ancestors ate in the land of Egypt. All who are hungry, come and eat. All who are needy, come and celebrate Passover with us. This year we are here. Next year we will be in Israel. This year we are slaves. Next year we will be free.
Fantastic. Thank you. So as we sing this song, this is the Halachma song. Hold it 1 second. Let me get it. I do not.
I don't think it was in there.
It was not in there. Okay. Well, it is going to be up here right now. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to waste any more time putting it back up. So let us do these few words in Hebrew, which means, again, this is the bread of affliction. Halach ma anya. And I'm going to turn it over to Wendy for this song.
Hold on. Pulling it up the page.
So now we're going to begin to tell the tale of Passover. We're going to do the actual part of the service that's kind of the longest part. It's the part that we call the Magid part, which again is telling this tale, telling the story. And we begin telling the story with, again, and if you want to pour your second cup of wine or grape juice, I mean, your second cup of wine, this is the second cup of grape juice, you can do that, but we're not going to have it till we're done telling the story. But we begin telling the story with Halachma. This is the bread of poverty. This is the bread that we ate when we were poor, and we use it as a lesson to make sure that anyone's poor, or if anyone doesn't have food, we have to make sure we're going to do it. Now, this year, by the way, our temple did something very special. We made sure that every senior in Santa Clarita that's getting Meals on Wheels was able to get a Passover meal as well. And that was done through the bat mitzvah project, the mitzvah project that Sammy and her family decided to do. So we were able to get meals now to 90 people. We had to make a deadline for it because we had to make sure we could cook the food for everybody. But we've got 90 people in Santa Clarita, seniors who otherwise are not going to be able to have Passover, that are going to be able to have Passover now because of us, and because we take this very seriously, this idea that, again, everyone who needs to have food should be able to have it, at least, if not every day, then for sure on Passover, the day we think about being people who were poor, who were slaves at one point. So now we come to one of the most famous parts of a Passover Seder, especially for our young people, for kids, which of course is the four questions. And a lot of you are going to have this responsibility to do this. So I would love to be able to hear at least some people doing this on out loud. So Wendy, what do you think we can do now?
That's a very good question. We can unmute everybody and everybody can try and sing along, although we won't all be in sync, but it would be cool to hear everybody's voices in the background.
Yep. So we're going to try to do this. Wendy's going to play it. It's going to be a little tricky, but we're going to try it. So we're going to do the four questions, and then we'll read them in English. There's really not four questions. There's one question. Why is this night different than all other nights? And then four answers. But really, the four answers lead to more questions. So everyone's always called it the four questions. It's really one question with four answers. But that's okay. We call it the four questions. But if you think about it, there's only one question mark. Why is this night different? So, here we go.
Ma nishtana ha-layla hazeh mikol ha-laylot, mikol ha-laylot. Shevechol ha-laylot anu ochlin ha-meitzu matzah, ha-meitzu matzah. Ha-layla hazeh, ha-layla hazeh, lo matza alayla haze alayla haze kulo matza shevcho halelot anu ochlin she'ayerakot alayla haze alayla haze maror maror alayla haze alayla haze maror maror shevcho halelot in anu matpilin afilu pa'am echad afilu pa'am echad alayla haze alayla haze shetet pe'amim alayla haze alayla haze shetet pe'amim Shevcho halelot anu ochlin ben yoshvin uvein mesubim ben yoshvin uvein mesubim halayla hazeh halayla hazeh kulanu mesubim halayla hazeh halayla hazeh kulanu mesubim.
Fantastic, everybody. So we're going to do one other thing before we move on to the four questions in English, which is going to be read. Sammy, you're supposed to do this, right? In English. Why don't you do it in English first? Why don't you do your part first, Sammy?
Me?
Okay. Yep. Sammy.
On all other nights, we eat both leavened bread and matzah. Tonight, we only eat matzah.
Mm-hmm. Keep going.
On all other nights, we eat all kinds of vegetables, but tonight we only eat bitter herbs. On all other nights, we expect to dip our vegetables once in one time. Tonight, we do it twice. On all other nights, we eat sitting or normally reclining. Tonight we recline.
Very good. So I'm going to play one really quick version of the four questions. What?
Oh, sorry. I'm still on mute. My dog was just right here.
That's okay. I'm going to play one quick video that I got last year from one of our friends. She did a really cool version of the four questions. She did it really quick. This is one of the stars of it's one of the stars of the Big Bang Theory and a new show too, Mayim Bialik, doing the four questions. Oh wait, it's on mute.
Shebechol Halelos Anu Ochlin Chametz Umatzah. Halayla ze, halayla haze, kulo matzah. Shebechol halelos, anu ochlin she'ar yerakos. Halayla ze, halayla haze, maror, maror. Shebechol halelos, ein anu matbilim afilu pa'am echas. Halayla ze, halayla ze, shestei fe'amim. Halayla ze, halayla ze, shestei fe'amim. Shebechol halelos, anu achlin, ben yoshvinu ven mesubin. Halayla ze, halayla ze, kulanu mesubin.
So what'd you think of that, guys? Pretty cool, right? She did a pretty good job singing the four questions. That was not an easy thing to do. She did a good job. Well, it is kind of easy, but she probably hasn't done it for a long time because usually the youngest kid gets to do the four questions. So now she's a mom and has a lot of kids. Not a lot of kids. She has kids of her own, but she probably did them a long time ago as a kid. But anyways, we're going to now continue on and we're going to sing another song, which I think is this one in our song sheet? Wendy, Avadim Hayinu?
Yes, it is. It's song number 5.
Yep, I see it there at the bottom. I'm going to put this one up. Here we go. It's right there at the bottom. Avadim Hayinu. We were slaves in Egypt, but we're not slaves anymore.
Avadim Hayinu, Hayinu, Ata b'nei Chorin, b'nei Chorin. Avadim Hayinu, Ata, Ata b'nei Chorin. Avadim Hayinu, Ata, Ata b'nei Chorin.
Thank you. And we're going to turn back into our Haggadah for a translation of what we just read and kind of what does it mean to be slaves? I'm going to turn it back over to Sophia. Avadim Hayinu.
We were slaves to Pharaoh, and God took us out of Egypt there with a strong hand and outstretched arm. Had God not brought our ancestors out of captivity, then even today and our children and our grandchildren would still be slaves. Even if we were all wise, knowledgeable scholars and Torah experts, we would still be obligated. It blacked out for me.
Sorry. Yep. Is it back yet?
Yes. Okay. We would still be obligated to tell the story of the Exodus.
Thank you. And we're actually going to now try to do something. This might be a little too much, but I don't care. We're going to try. We're going to try to do the four children because we normally do this as parts. So I want especially the people who are the younger kids who are not going to be able to be leading this year, but next year you will be. Our Vav class and our Hay and younger students, you're going to be leading Seder before you know it. But in the meantime, we want you to definitely be involved today with some parts. And this is the part. So we're going to try to do this And we're going to do the four children. And some people say the four sons, but it's not the four sons. It can be the four children. We're going to have you guys do this. So we're going to try to do this and have people do their parts, do this part. So we're going to try to get you to do it. So you're going to have to be ready to unmute yourself. And I'm not going to do this in any special order. Everyone always laughs if you get to be the wicked child. Why did I get to be picked as the wicked child? By the way, it's a good thing to be the wicked child, by the way. You should know the wicked child has the longest part. What you're supposed to say to them is actually the longest part and actually very important part. So let's start. We're going to start right here, which says, we tell the story. And we learn it from all angles. It's our job to make the story accessible to all members of our community. So we can think how we might best reach every type of child. Now there's not four types. There's every type of child is a little different, but four is a symbolic number. The first child, the wise child. What does the wise child say? And this wise child shall be Zoe. You're the wise child. What does the wise child say? Asks. Can you read that part, Zoe? You're unmuted. I'm trying to unmute you. Go, Zoe. What does the wise child ask? Right here. What are the testimonies? That's your part. This is already turning out to be more difficult than I wanted. That's your part, Zoe. Go for it, right there. You see it, Zoe? All right. You don't see it? It's highlighted. All right. Let's try Sadie. Sadie, you try this part. What are the testimonies?
What are the testimonies and laws which God commanded you?
Perfect. And we're supposed to teach this child the rules of observing the holiday of Passover. And now we can go to the next child, the wicked child. Now, who are we going to pick to be the wicked child this time? Who shall be the wicked child? I think, Bo would like to be the wicked child. There you go. What does the wicked child ask? Bo, what does the wicked child
ask? The wicked child asks, what does this service mean to you?
Yeah, but what does he do? He says, to you, right? The emphasis on you. To you and not herself or himself, because he or she takes herself or himself out of the community and misses the point. You're supposed to set this child's teeth on edge and say, it is because of what God did for me in taking me out of Egypt, me and not you, right? Because if that child had been there, you would have been left behind because you didn't want to be part of the community. So don't take yourself out of the community, wicked child. Next, we come to the simple child, the Tom. What does the Tom child say? What is the simple child? This might be somebody who just doesn't really, again, can't figure things out or just doesn't really understand what's going on around them or her. So who shall be this simple child? Jonah, would you like to be the simple
Looks
child?
Looks like Max.
Simple
Max child. Max has his hand up.
Oh, Max? Wait, where's Max? Oh, Max's hand is up. I don't see Max. Okay, Max, you go for it. Max, what's the simple child say?
The simple child says, what is this?
Right. What is this? And to this child, answer plainly, with a strong hand, God took us out of Egypt where we were slaves. So there's something to say for that child too. And then we come to the fourth child. This child can be Jonah. Jonah, the fourth child doesn't know how to ask anything. So the fourth child doesn't really say anything. Just go like this. Jonah, just go like this. I don't know. What do you say when you don't know something? I don't know. You just shrug. Well, even for this child who doesn't even know how to ask or what to say, you start telling the story and you say, it's because of what God did for me when taking me out of Egypt. And so you start that child, you prompt that child with something so that even that child who can't even ask or doesn't want to ask, now, I will tell you, there's a story that there's actually not a story, but there's a teaching that there's actually a fifth child. And that's the child that's not even at Passover, because there's a lot of people that don't even know about Passover and they don't really know that there's even four children. That's really sad. And for those children, for those people, we have to really find a way to get them to come to Passover. So that's one of the things that we want to do, is we want to try to get people who have no other place to go. We have to try to get them to come to Passover. That's one of our jobs. Every one of us, not just me, not just the rabbi, everybody is supposed to try to work in getting those people who don't have a place to come for Passover to have a place to come. All right. So the next song is Vehisha Amda. This song is, oh, wait a second. Is it in the Haggadah?
There's a gray block. Yeah, in front
it's
of
right
everything.
There. Yep. Sorry. It's right here. I was going to put it on from the other Haggadah, but we don't need to do that. So this part right here, I'm turning it back over to, this is Xander's part right here, Vehisha Amda, but we're going to sing it in Hebrew first. This is the part of the Seder where, again, some people will raise their cup. Some people will raise their cup and do the Vehisha Amda, but we'll sing it in Hebrew first. It's only four words in Hebrew.
I'm going to do a very short version. Vehisha Amda, Vehisha Amda, Lavo.
So much going on my screen. Now, Xander, it's your turn to read this part in English. What Vehisha Amda means?
For not only one enemy has risen against us to annihilate us, but in every generation there are those who rise against us. But God saves us from those who seek to harm us.
Yep. And we read throughout history of those enemies who try to come against us and who try to destroy the Jewish people. It's not just during the time of Pharaoh, but it's been in many other times, unfortunately, in history. So one of the things that we remind ourselves every year at Passover is, in the years our ancestors lived in Egypt, our numbers grew, and soon the family of Jacob became the people of Israel. Pharaoh and his advisors grew alarmed by how great the nation grew, was growing within their borders, so they enslaved us. We were forced to perform hard labor, perhaps even building pyramids. Our oppressors, not the really big pyramids that you see that are around, even older than that, but there were other pyramids in other cities we did build. Our oppressors feared that even as slaves, the Israelites might grow strong and rebel. So Pharaoh decreed that Israelite baby boys should be drowned to prevent the Israelites from overthrowing those who had enslaved them. But God heard the cries of the Israelites, and God brought us out of Egypt with a strong hand and outstretched arm, with great awe, miraculous signs and wonders. God brought us not out by angel or messenger, but through God's own intervention. And one of the most famous parts of telling this story is the 10 plagues. And again, it's one of those things that we kind of think about. We sometimes even joke about it, but it's not really, really funny, because it is a serious thing that people died. It was a serious thing that people suffered. And of course, when we go through the 10 plagues, especially this year and last year, we were thinking about our own plagues, and the fact that since we had Passover last year to this year, we've lost over 500,000 people in our country from Corona. And so from a virus that, again, we didn't even know about, you know, 14, 15 months ago, we didn't even know it existed. And now we have literally, again, 500,000 people that are gone. That's more people in this country. That's more people that live in all of Santa Clarita combined. It's kind of hard to think about that. And it's hard to, again, realize that, forget Santa Clarita, there's a lot of other cities, big cities in the country, that be the, everybody in the whole city was gone. So this has been a hard year for our country and for the world. That's just in America. America's had more people die than any other country, but lots of other countries have had people die, and pretty much almost every country's had a few people, but at least a few people. So as we go through the 10 plagues, we of course want to think about the modern plagues that we have. And again, as we go through these plagues, we'll say them, And we are going to go through the plagues and say each one, take out a little bit of our cup as we say each plague. So, Wendy, are you going to do this part in Hebrew? I can't remember what we said.
We didn't say anything. I do have a plague song to the tune of This Old Man, but I don't know if you want to just read the...
Yeah, we're going to do that. We'll do the 10 plagues, and we'll do go down Moses next after that.
Okay.
Okay, ready? So we'll do the 10 plagues. We'll do them in Hebrew and English. Dom.
Blood.
Blood. Sfardea.
Frogs.
Kinim.
Lice.
Arov.
Beasts.
Dever.
Cattle disease.
Shechin.
Boils.
Barad.
Hail.
Arbe.
Locusts.
Hoshech.
Darkness.
Makat Bechorot.
Death of the firstborn.
So again, as you think about the plagues, the fact that plagues originally affected the Jews and the Egyptians together, but eventually, of course, they've just affected the Egyptians. And again, you can see the plagues kind of like cartoon drawings of them, but again, pretty scary. Not a really just a kid's kind of thing, but we kind of make it kind of, for some reason we've always done that, because I guess maybe it takes on the imagination. What do you think, Wendy? Why do you think people kind of turn this into something to sing about, and why do you think people do that?
Because I think for kids, who the story is meant to teach the next generation, which is the kids, and I think some of the things that happen are very scary and could give kids bad dreams, or kids might not even understand what they are.
Yeah.
And even knows what locusts or boils.
We definitely don't want people to be scared about it. I just don't know if talking about it makes it scary. But anyways, it was always strange to me that we make
light of it. Yeah. But it's not.
Because it is kind of scary. And maybe I'm more sensitive to it now because of the year we've just had, but all of a sudden plagues don't seem so funny to me. But again, we do think about the fact that we have other plagues around us too that we need to work on getting rid of. So let's hope we do that. Let's hope we get rid of those plagues, like pollution. And we always think about the other plagues that we have, crime and any kinds of poverty or anything that's making our world not as good as it could be. That's a plague, right? So definitely think about climate change, all those kinds of different things. All right. But now we're going to come down to our next song that we sing, which is the Let My People Go. Is it called Let My People Go or Go Down Moses? What's the song?
Go Down Moses. But you know what I think would be fun to do for this one? So kids, if you see that almost every other line in capital letters, it says Let My People Go, I want you guys to yell that. Because that's what Moses was saying to Pharaoh, let my people go. He didn't just say, hey, Pharaoh, you know, would you let my people go? Yeah, we just want to go. No, he was pleading. So here's what I would love to do, Rabbi. If we could put all the kids' video up and unmute everybody so that when we get to that part, I can see and hear everybody yell to Pharaoh, let my people go. And I'll sing the rest.
My only question is, can I do that while I still share, though?
No, but I don't think we need to share because.
Okay, no.
I think
that's
why I'm thinking the kids can just see.
Just stop sharing. I think most people know this song pretty well too.
All right, let's see. I got to put it on gallery view because I just pretty much see myself. I know what I look like.
All right, everybody should be on gallery view today.
There we go. Now I see a whole bunches of people. All right. Everybody's muted. You have to unmute yourself so I can hear you yell, let my people go. And you're going to shake your fist. Of course, you can't see my fist. There we go. Let my people go. I still see everybody's muted. Unmute.
I did.
I see some people are unmuted.
I already did.
There we go.
All right. Guys.
Here we go. When Israel was in Egypt land. Let me hear it.
Let go.
Oppressed so hard they could not stand. Let me hear it.
Let my people go.
Then we can all say, go down, Moses. Go down, Moses. Last time, make it really loud. Here we go.
Let my people go.
Now we're talking.
That's the last time I want to ever sing Passover songs. The last year I ever want to have to do this again.
You know what? There's another song right after that on the song sheet. Yep. Oh, listen.
That's right. We got to.
And the kids can say no, no, no. So we can unmute for that one too. So everybody that just muted.
Do you want me to put these songs up or not? This one.
Yeah, you can put it up
so you can see it. Ready?
Right. But everybody unmute because I want to hear everybody yell. Because now you're saying from Pharaoh's point of view, because you're the mean Pharaoh. No, no, no. I will not let them go. So you're going to, that's it. You shake your finger. No. And you can say it in whatever silly voice you want, but you have to unmute. Everybody's muted again. And the screen is black. We don't see the song sheet. We still don't see the song sheet. We just see gray. And some people are still muted. Oh, it was there for a half a second.
See it?
There we go. Song number three. See where it says no, no, no? Really loud. Oh, listen. Oh, listen. Oh, listen, King Pharaoh. Oh, listen. Oh, listen. Please let my people go. They want to go away. They work so hard all day. King Pharaoh. King Pharaoh. What do you say? Say your loud, mean King Pharaoh voice. You ready?
No,
no, no.
I will not let them go.
No, no, no.
I will not let them go. Because I'm mean.
That's pretty. You know, listen, our next song is actually in the Haggadah too, but I know it's also in here too. We're going to do this song right now, which is Dayenu. So I'm going to keep it on this sheet rather than going back to the book, back to the Haggadah. We're going to do Dayenu, which means it would have been enough for us. Any of the things that God did for us, saving us with the plagues, bringing us out through the Red Sea, feeding us in the desert, manna for 40 years, that we got food. God provided food for us, so we didn't even have to like hunt or fish or anything like that, or even like raise crops. We had manna, and then we got brought into the land of Israel, and we got things like the Torah in the desert, in the wilderness. We got Shabbat. We got this great gift of having a day off every week, like a holiday every week. No one else has that kind of life where we get a holiday every week. We do. We're supposed to have a holiday off every week, Shabbat. So we're going to sing this song, Dayenu. It would have been enough. So we're going to sing, if God had brought us out of Egypt, that would have been enough. But God also gave us the Torah. So we're going to sing this part right now.
Okay, so you can leave yourself muted if you want. And you can clap your hands or you can slap the table so you make some percussive sound. Ilu hotzi hotzianu hotzianu mi mitzrayim. Hotzianu mi mitzrayim dayenu. Here we go. Dayenu. Da da yenu, da da yenu, da yenu, da yenu, da yenu, da da yenu, da da yenu, da da yenu, da yenu, da yenu. Ilu natan natan lanu natan lanu et haShabbat natan lanu et haShabbat da yenu. Everybody, da da yenu. Da da yenu, natanatalanu natalanu et hatara natalanu et hatara dainu. Here we go. Dai dainu, dai dainu, dai dainu, 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 dai dainu, dai dainu, dai.
So that is a great song. So Miss Winnie, what's the next song you have on your sheet to do?
Let's see. We can do song number 6. There's so many good songs. It's so hard to choose.
There are a lot of good songs.
So I'm going to guess most people did not have a chance to go to a ball game, but maybe you know the song, Take Me Out to the Ball Game, but we're going to sing Take Us Out of Egypt. And you can sway back and forth. Take us out of Egypt, free us from slavery. Bake us some matzah in a haste. Don't worry about flavor, give no thought to taste. Oh, it's rush, rush, rush to the Red Sea. If we don't cross, it's a shame. For it's 1, 2, 10 plagues, you're out at the pace of history game. Take me out to the Seder. Take me out with the crowd. Read the Haggadah and don't skip a word. Please hold your talking, we want to be heard. So let's root, root, root for the leader, that he will finish his spiel. So we nosh, 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 and by gosh, so let's eat the meal.
All right. So now we're going to go back to our Haggadah. We're going to get to the next part, which is actually going to be read by Sammy. So I'm going to turn it back over to her. Hold on a second. This up here, sharing this very important part of the Seder. I like to say every year, it's my favorite line in the Seder because it's really, really important. The whole Dor Vador. Hayav Adam Lirod Et Atzmo Ki Ilu Hu Yatza Mimitzrayim. Which, Sammy, what does that mean?
What? Oh, sorry.
Right here.
In every generation, everyone is obligated to see himself, herself, as though they pass passionately left Egypt.
Uh-huh. Keep going.
The Seder reminds us that it was not only our ancestors whom God reminded us to along with them. That's what the Torah says. God brought us from there in order to lead us and give us the land promised to our ancestors.
Very good. Thank you. And so, Sammy, what it teaches us, and everybody, remember, it's not like our ancestors were just redeemed thousands of years ago, but all of us, and we're supposed to feel that way every Passover, like we ourselves were freed, not people who lived a long time ago, not even people who lived a couple generations ago, but each one of us are supposed to feel like we were redeemed so that we never forget and personally learn from it and don't think that this is ancient history, because people can be turned into slaves even in our own day. And we're supposed to learn from it, of course, that we're always supposed to treat people with dignity because we had our dignity taken away. And so as we think about freedom in our own generation, and as again, we just take a moment. I want everyone here to feel like you were a slave for a moment. I want you to picture yourself back in Egypt. And I want you to picture yourself, not somebody else, but you yourself leaving Egypt and becoming a free person, crossing the Sea of Reeds, having matzah for that first time, and knowing that you're not going to be a slave anymore. So now we have our second cup, which is the part that we do as we finish telling the tale, as we finish the Magid part, which is the main part of the Seder. We say, Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Borei Pri Hagafen. So, that is the next part. All right. All right. And as we go through this last part of the Seder, the part after we've finished telling the tale, there's also obviously a few times to sing songs. So, Wendy, what's our next song?
We're going to do song number 7 because it's fun. And I think I'm going to have all the kids stand up just because everybody's been sitting too long. This is an old rock song. And I want you to put on your rock and roll persona. You're in the rock and roll Passover mode. And your part is going to say, where is it? In the chorus where it says, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, pretend you're rocking your baby. Let my people go. And then you do your rock and roll, I don't know, whatever kind of sign you want to, yeah, 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 yeah. And you can sing it along with me. So we're going to tell the story. A burning bush told me just the other day that I should go down to Egypt and say, hey, it's time to let my people be free. So listen to God if you won't listen to me. Here you go. A Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. I said a Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Well, me and my people, we're going to the Red Sea. Pharaoh's army coming after me. Well, I took my staff, I put it in the sand, and all of God's people walked on dry lands. I sang it, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. I said, oh, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. That's the story of the stubborn goat. Pharaohs should know, hey, chariots don't float. The lesson's simple and it's easy to find. When God says go, hey, you'd better mind. A Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go.
So, as Jennifer pointed out, you're supposed to use your tambourines for those kind of songs. Does everybody have their tambourines? Go get your tambourines. There you go. Got your tambourines. That's definitely a song for tambourine, right, Wendy?
I didn't know they had them.
Yeah, they have their tambourines. Their tambourines are part of what's special this year at Passover. We never gave away tambourines. That was a great idea, Wendy. That's all Jennifer's idea, to have tambourines for everybody for Passover. But really important that you have them with your family Seder. But we're going to practice. We're going to do a song. The next song we'll do, I promise, Wendy, we'll do tambourine, right?
Okay.
Do a little tambourine, a little tambourine action. So, and they can decorate those tambourines. That's what the cool thing is, Wendy. They get to decorate those tambourines.
Oh, nice.
So we're going to come back into the Haggadah. We're going to now do another hand washing. And again, as we wash our hands, and this time, spilled a little too much water there. As we have a chance to wash our hands, and now we're going to have matzah in just a moment. This is a time for us to say the blessing over washing our hands, which we're supposed to do whenever we eat a meal with food, which again, I'm going to make it so you can say it. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, asher kidshanu b'mitzvot tzivanu, al netilat yadayim. We praise you, God, who makes us holy through mitzvot, through commandments, obligations, commanding us to wash our hands. So that's a mitzvah, everybody. Oh, I just realized my video's off. So sorry, you didn't just see me wash my hands. I just washed my hands. And I spilled a little too much water on myself, actually, too. So, but I'm very clean right now. But so again, this was goes back to well before we had diseases and stuff that people are thinking about now. So everybody get a little matzah ready. A little matzah. Get some matzah ready for yourself, next to yourself, because we're going to say the blessing over matzah, which is two blessings at our Seder. Normally, on Passover, it is our bread. For the week or so of Passover, we have matzah instead of bread. But during the Seder, because we're doing a mitzvah, we're actually fulfilling a Torah commandment during the Seder. It's so cool that we get to do something that we've been doing for thousands of years with our family, with our friends, this time on Zoom, whatever. But we're doing something that Jewish people have been doing for thousands of years, since the very first Seder, which was held in Egypt. The very first Seder, folks, was in Africa. It was celebrated by Jews who were slaves in Africa, Jewish people. And they celebrated Passover that first night with matzah, and we're doing it thousands of years later, which is amazing to think about. So when we have this first piece of matzah, we say the blessing, two blessings. So we say them before we actually eat the matzah, two blessings. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, hamotzi lechem min haaretz. And the second blessing, Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al achilat matzah. We thank you, God, for the mitzvah, the commandment to eat matzah. So everybody take a little matzah, eat a little of your matzah. Okay, now, I don't know if anybody has bitter herb around their table. The maror is definitely something that we're supposed to eat now. And again, if we don't have any maror, any bitter herb, people use horseradish. Some people use, by the way, romaine lettuce. So you can get a little piece of lettuce out of the refrigerator if you want. You don't have to have actually horseradish. You can have bitter herb. That's literally a lot of people used to use for a long time. They used romaine lettuce, which some people just eat in a salad nowadays, but it used to be considered a pretty bitter type of lettuce.
So about arugula, that's even more bitter.
That's a bitter, you're really, but I think romaine was just like maybe more common or something. I don't know. But that was a lot of people used romaine. So this is the blessing over maror, which again is another mitzvah, because the Torah tells us to eat bitter herb on this holiday, to actually make our taste buds taste a little bitterness. So let's say the blessing over eating a little maror, which is Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al achilat maror. So as again, fulfilling this mitzvah of bitter herb. Now the next step is actually eating a little bit of matzah and bitter herb, and a little bit of haroset, a little bit of the special food that we make that's like the mortar, like the clay that we made into bricks, building the cities for the Pharaoh. This is a tradition of having the three foods together, because Rabbi Hillel, one of our greatest teachers, 2,000 years ago, said it says we're supposed to eat Pesach Matzah Maror, the Pesach offering, which we don't have anymore, so we use Haroset in its place. Matzah and Maror, if it says you're supposed to eat three, maybe you're supposed to eat three of them in one bite. And again, he was very famous. He said, if I'm not for myself, who will be for me? If I'm not for others, what am I? And if not now, when? So guess what? Something to think about all the time is, what does it mean to take care of others, take care of yourself too, and not to wait around to do those things. Get on it. Get on it now. We're going to finish up this last part of the Seder with, normally we'd be eating food. We don't have that food. And the last part of the food that we're supposed to eat is the afikoman, which a lot of people know is the last piece of matzah that we're supposed to eat. Now, normally, what do? We find the afikoman, we search for it, and we hide a few afikoman pieces, a few matzah pieces. That's one tradition people have. Some people have the kids hide it, and the grown-ups have to find it. And well, the way we always did it, the kids hid it, and I mean, we hid it, and the kids had to find it. But what we're going to do right now is I've got a chance for you to find the afikoman. This I've just put up on the screen. There's an afikoman hidden here, and you have to raise your hand. The first person who finds the afikoman is going to get a prize. There's an afikoman in this image, hidden in this image. This is a virtual afikoman search I came up with this year. I'm not the only person who's doing this, I know. But find the afikoman, raise your hand when you've got it and tell me where it is. You have to unmute yourself and tell me where it is. So raise your hand if you can find the afikoman hidden in this picture, everybody. Hopefully you're not looking on a telephone. If you're looking on a telephone, it's going to be hard. If you're on an iPad, a little harder. If you're on your computer, especially like a big screen, really easy. If you're on a television, you're almost cheating. There is an afikoman. Raise your hand when you found it. It's there. Shouldn't take this long. Let me find it. Who's got it? You got to tell me where on the picture it is. Actually, you know what? You know what I'm going to do?
I think I found it.
Okay, I'm going to allow it. You can annotate. Annotate it. Draw on it when you've got it. Whoever's got it, draw on it. If you draw wrong, you're out, though. So I'm not going to let people draw all over this. If you're wrong, then you're wrong. You're out. Does somebody draw on it? Somebody circle it? Yep, there you got it. Who got that? Sophia? Sophia got it. There it is. Sophia got it. Guess what? Sophia gets a prize. But you know what I did?
Looks like Sophia might know.
Sophia got it. It's already done. She got it. Where have you been? We got a winner. But guess what? I've got another one. I got a second prize. So, Sophia, you're not eligible, but you can help your siblings if you want. There's a second one. This one's harder. One more. You guys, I put up another afikoman for you to find. Find the afikoman, folks. Annotate where you find it. But if you're wrong, you're out. If you annotate incorrectly. This one's a tough one.
We can't annotate, but we found it.
Where is it? Who said that?
Lacey and Sadie.
Okay, tell me where it is.
It's behind like one of the
meters. There's multiple.
Just give me upper, lower. Where is it?
It's lower.
Which side?
On the right.
Okay, tell me if I'm getting hot or cold.
Warmer. There.
There it is.
Wait.
Wait, past it.
Right there.
Yep.
It's right there. Yes, you got it.
Guys are good.
That was a hard one. That was fun, right? So you guys can do that. You can do that at your own Seders too. You can do a virtual. You do a virtual afikoman hunt. It's cool, right? I like that. What do you think of that, Wendy? Is that good?
I thought that was great. I couldn't find it.
It's like a Waldo.
I couldn't find either one of them.
It's Waldo. No, the second one was really hard. The second one I had a hard time with. But it's like finding Waldo. You guys don't remember finding Waldo because you're not old enough.
I mean, before their time.
It wasn't even that long ago. It's just... It was like 15 years ago that Waldo books were big. 20 years ago? I don't even know. But good job. So we're going to get a prize over to Sophia and Lacey. You guys got a prize for finding an afikoman. We did it. You see? You can't stop us from finding an afikoman. Doing an afikoman search. You think that could happen? No. No way. We're going to find a way to do that. do those crazy things. All right, well, we're going to finish up with the last couple songs. Everybody knows we got one big song coming up, but we need everybody for it, which is Chag Yad Ya. But before we do that, let me just share back up one little thing up here on the screen, because it is very important, by the way. I want to tell you, even in the midst of everything that's going on right now, it's very important to be thankful. And I want to have Xander, please give us the blessing after the meal. When we're done eating, we're supposed to say a blessing of thanks. So Xander, would you please give me that Birkat Hamazon, that blessing after the meal?
We praise God, ruler of everything, whose goodness sustains the world. You are the origin of love and compassion, the source of bread for all. Thanks to you, we need never lack for food. You provide food enough for everyone. We praise God, source of food for everyone.
Thank you, Xander. And we have a tradition of finishing that off with the third bracha, the third blessing over grape juice, the Kiddush.
Baruch Atanai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Borei Peri HaGafen. Amen.
Thank you, Wendy. Now, we have another cup. Cup for Elijah. This is the cup for Elijah. And who is Elijah, Sophia? Why don't you read this part right here before we start?
Jonah, we started a book about Elijah.
Tradition holds that he will return in advance of Messianic days to herald a new era of peace. So we set a place for Elijah at many joyous, hopeful Jewish occasions, such as a baby's bris and the Passover Seder.
That's right. In every Havdalah, the end of every Shabbat, we sing the song of welcoming Eliyahu. Eliyahu Anavi, because he is the guy who announces that this good time is coming, this time of peace, a time when people will all get along, when people don't have to worry about illness, things like that. We're going to sing Eliyahu. So normally we're going to stand for this. So if you want to stand, you can get up out of your seat, and you can stand for Eliyahu Anavi.
Eliyahu Hanavi, Eliyahu Hatishbi, Eliyahu, Eliyahu, Eliyahu Hagiladi, Bimhera.
So that's one of the songs that we normally sing for Elijah towards the end of the Seder. And that's, again, one of the things that people remember is one of the kind of the traditions of Passover. We also have, again, one more cup, which is the cup of finishing up the Seder, a cup of singing and festivals and thinking about completing the end of the Seder. We began the Seder with a drink. As we come to the end of the Seder, we drink one more glass of wine. With this final cup, we give thanks for the experience of celebrating Passover together, for the traditions that help inform our daily lives and guide our actions and aspirations so we can be better people. So let's sing the Kiddush for the fourth time.
Baruch Atanai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Borei Peri HaGafen. Amen.
All right. So now we finish with our last few songs that we always finish with. And again, I want to thank everybody for staying on. We had a great a great Seder because we had Wendy with us, and Wendy usually is there for our musical Seders and all the music that we do. But one of the things that we're going to do now is the Chad Gad Yah song, which is the song where we make the noises of the different parts of the story, which talks about a goat, one little goat that my father bought for 2 zuzim, which is like $5. And this goat got eaten. And then there's a cat that ate the goat and dog bites the cat, etc. So what we'd like to do is we like to make the noises of the different things. And this part, we definitely need you guys to sing along for this. So we're going to go through these pieces, and this is really kind of like the last song that we all do together. And I want to see everybody. We got to get everybody together for this song to do the different voices. So Sophia, I see you're the only person at your table. We need your siblings here because they count in this song as a voices for the different things. So let's bring them over. And Bo, we're going to need everybody to unmute. Sadie, we need to see you on, and we can get Lacey. She's there too. She can sing along too, even though she's a graduate of our school. She can make those noises too. But this one is a little bit easier to sing because, except for the chorus, the voices you can make, we can have a little delay. So that's okay. So everybody unmute yourselves. Jordan and Bo and Max and Zoe. Sadie, everybody unmute yourselves for this because I'm going to give out the parts. So the first, of course, is the goat. Who's going to be the goat? This is the part that's the most. Who's the goat?
Some people are still muted.
Some people are still muted. Yes, that's true. Who's going to be the goat? This is the one that's, this person's got to be on the ball because they've got to do it the most. Who's doing goat? Who's doing the goat?
Max or Bo?
Who's doing it?
Okay, Bo.
Bo's the goat. So he makes the ba, ma, or ba. You make that sound. That's the sound of the goat. And then the next is the cat. Who's going to make the song of the cat? That's the second most.
Cat meow.
Who's making the cat sound? Who loves cats?
Max.
Who's making the cat sound? Who is making cat sounds? Come on, guys. I don't want to spend all day figuring out who's doing what part. Okay, Wendy. Who's doing the cat sound?
I guess I'm going to just... Okay. Jen. Miss Jen.
All right. Who's doing the dog?
Me.
Who?
Max.
Max is doing... Okay, Max. All right, Max. You're up for that. I gotta do this so that I know who's doing what, because this is hard. This is not easy to do on Zoom. I want to tell you that. We're gonna do it. We're not gonna be deprived. So who's doing the stick? Who's the stick?
Xander.
Xander's the stick. Whack. He's whacking that thing. Now who's the fire? Who's the fire?
Fire sounds like Jonah.
Jonah, are you the fire?
Sure. No.
No. Was it? No. Jonah, you gotta be something there. So you're
I'll
either.
I'll do it with you. I'll do it with you.
Sounds.
What?
We'll do it together.
Okay. Jonah will be the fire. Okay. And Sophia, who's the water sound? Water sound.
Sounds like a twin.
Who's that? Which one? Is it Jordan or Zoe?
Zoe.
Okay. All right. Next, we have the ox.
Jordan.
Okay, making a moo sound. All right. Then we've got the slaughterer. The slaughterer.
Uh-oh. Where's Sammy?
Sammy's the slaughterer.
Okay.
Now, who's the angel of death? Who's the angel of death?
I might have to be you.
Well, wait a sec. We still have other parts. I don't see everybody has a part.
I know, but I see a little face down there that could. shouldn't be the angel of death.
Who's Sadie?
Yeah, she shouldn't be the angel of death.
Sadie, but if you're God, you're only at the very end. Sadie, do you want to be the cat? Sadie doesn't want to be a cat. Uh-oh. So she'll be God. You'll be God, Sadie, okay?
Woo, Sadie!
you only have one line at the end, but it's okay. But you have to come up with what God says. You have to come up with a good one. All right, so I'm the angel of death. All right.
I have an idea how we can use the tambourines.
Yep.
Cha-ching.
Okay, there you go. There's our money. Everybody get your thing for two zuzim. That's the two zuzim, folks. That is the sound of money. Very good, Wendy. That is our two zuzim. Does everybody have a part? I'm looking through here. Yeah, everybody has a part now. Everybody's got a part. So now I'm going to put up the words. Well, really don't need the words, but I'm just going to put them up for a second. This is actually
the kids are still muted.
Yeah, everyone's got to be off mute. The words really aren't important here because, again, we're only singing the Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah. So there, don't really worry about the words. I'll show it one more time so you can see it, but it's literally all you're seeing is Chod God Yah. One goat. All right.
That sticker came up too.
Everybody ready?
And everybody can sing this with me.
I can't. You got a Q-tip.
Let's do the Chod God Yah part.
Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
Right. All right. I think that was pretty good.
My father fought for two zuzim.
Ching, come on.
It goes cha-ching. Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
So my father bought a goat. Bo.
Ba.
Good. My father
bought for two zuzim.
Cha-ching. All those tambourines.
Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
Then came the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat. Nice.
My father bought for two zuzim. Cha-ching. Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
Pretty good so far. Then came the dog. Max.
Who's the dog?
Max, you're all muted.
Rough.
Okay. Rough. That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought for two zuzim. Cha-ching. Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
Then came the stick.
Whack.
That beat the dog.
Ruff.
That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought for two zuzim. Cha-ching.
Pretty good. Then came the fire.
Crackle.
Okay. That was not a very enthusiastic fire. I wouldn't say that fire was on fire, but it was like more like a little flame, like burning on a candle. What a burning fire. Come on, guys. Let's be on fire now. All right. Then came the fire that burned the stick.
Whack.
That beat the dog.
Ruff.
That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought for two zuzim.
Cha-ching.
Chod God Yah. Chod God Yah.
Then came the water. Zoe, that's you. Don't mute yourself. You're unmuted. Now you're muted. Go. No, you're muted again. Go. All right. Unmute yourself, Zoe. You're muted. Okay. So unmute it. There you go. Came the fire that came the water that quenched the fire.
Crackle. We're about to say something.
That burned the stick.
Whack.
That beat the dog. That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat. That wasn't a good round. We got to do better. All right. It all starts here from the ox. It's all going to start from you, Jordan. Go. Then came the ox. What? That sounded like an ox. That sounded like an ox. That sounded like an ox had already become a burger. A burger. All right. They came the ox to drink the water. Zoe, that's you. That quenched the fire.
Crackle, crackle, crackle.
That burned the stick.
Whack.
That beat the dog.
Rough.
That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought four tools.
Ka-ching.
Ka-ching.
We only have three more times, so you better get this down. Then came the slaughterer.
Stab.
Who killed the ox. Who drank the water. They quenched the fire.
Crackle.
Here's your crackle.
Burn stick.
Back.
It beat the dog.
Ruff.
It bit the cat.
Meow.
It ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought four tools.
Oh, wait. Then came the angel of death. Hold on one second, folks. I showed our kids. This is my angel of death this year. Ready? Hold it a second. Ready? This is.
Oh, no.
Here's the angel of death.
I don't see it.
Oh, my God.
That's what we're working on for our we're doing a cartoon, an animated Pod God Yah that you'll see this week, folks. I'll post it up so you'll be able to see it when it's done. Anyways, it came the angel of death. Boo! Smote the slaughterer. The slaughterer, Sammy.
Stab.
Who killed the ox. That drank the water. That quenched the fire. Fire? Burn the stick.
Whack.
That bit the dog.
Ruff.
That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought four tools.
Cha-ching. All right, folks, this is the last one. So let's try to do this. Get it on time. So here comes the last line, the last verse. Then came God, the Holy One. Blessed be she.
I hope everybody's okay.
Aww.
Who smote the angel of death? Boo. Corona. Who also killed the slaughterer?
Bab.
Who killed the ox? Who drank the water? That quenched the fire.
Crackle.
That burned the stick.
Whack.
That beat the dog.
Ruff.
That bit the cat.
Meow.
That ate the goat.
Bah.
My father bought four tools.
Ka-ching.
Ka-ching.
Ka-ka-ya.
Fantastic. Everybody give their tambourine a good shake. Fantastic. Well, we're going to finish now with the last words that we're supposed to say at every Seder next year in Jerusalem. We pray that next year, much healthier, that next year people will be free, next year people won't be afraid of anything, that people will be living in peace and living in good health. So we're going to sing these last words, which represent for us Jerusalem as a place, but also Jerusalem as a state of mind, where people get to be in a place of peace, a place of shalom. So let's sing this song as we thank Wendy for leading us in music today. And thank you, Jen, for getting these prizes and these gifts to everybody, these treats to make Passover special. Let's sing a song of
and
hope.
Kids can use their tambourine.
Oh yeah,
we're gonna start off slowly with your tambourine. And so you gotta pay attention when we speed up. Lishana Hapa Lishana Hapa Lishana Ba Yerushalayim Lishana Hapa Lishana Hapa Lishana Hapa Lishana haba'a be'Yerushalayim Lishana haba'a Lishana haba'a be'Yerushalayim Lishana haba'a Lishana haba'a Lishana haba'a be'Yerushalayim Lishana haba'a Lishana haba'a Lishana haba'a be'Yerushalayim Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it!
Fantastic. Thank you everybody so much for being here. We want to wish you a great Passover. We hope you get to spend it with family, with friends. And again, this is only the last time, hopefully, that we'll ever have to do things only on Zoom. But again, everybody, thank you for being here and being part of it. And thank you to our Zion class for leading us in Seder too, everybody. Thank you for being there. And again, thank you again, Wendy, for making this so special. Everybody stay safe, stay healthy. And again, hope you guys are doing some good stuff. Spring break, Passover. All right, everybody, take care. Thanks, everyone, for being there.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Happy Passover. Happy Passover.